The Philippines reports three additional deaths linked to the Omicron variant, bringing the total to five. Three of them are senior citizens with comorbidities. As to their vaccination status, one was unvaccinated while another received a first dose. The inoculation status of the remaining three are still being verified. So far, the country has recorded 535 Omicron cases. The health department earlier said Omicron is now the predominant variant of COVID-19 in the Philippines. They also confirmed the detection of Omicron sublineage in the country. But for health experts, it shouldn't be a cause for panic.
It's causing more severe, or is it more severe than Omicron? I don't think so. For those vaccinated, I don't think it will evade immunity. If you recovered from an Omicron infection, I think your antibody against that will still protect you against that variant or lineage. And I don't think it can cause a more severe disease compared to Delta.
Hindi po natin kailangan mag-panic, because just with other variants, kailangan lang we continue to practice our safety protocols and have ourselves vaccinated, and we're going to be protected.
The Philippines' new COVID cases in the past 24 hours edged lower. The health department reported 15,789 new infections. The number of active cases has also gone down to 230,000. The 35.8% positivity rate reported today is the lowest since January 3. 66 additional deaths, as well as 32,000 new recoveries, were also recorded. Three labs were not able to submit data.
The Philippine government gives a 30-day window for workers in Metro Manila to get fully vaccinated. If they fail to comply, they'll be subject to the no vaccination, no ride policy. Transport officials reiterate the policy is not meant to discriminate, but to protect the unvaccinated. The 30-day window begins today.
Ang decision pong ito ay hindi absolute, sapagkat hindi po nito pinipigilan ang ating mga unvaccinated o partially vaccinated workers na bumiyahe matapos ang 30-day window. Maaari pa rin po silang bumiyahe, hindi nga lang gamit ang pampublikong transportasyon, kundi ang iba pang uri ng transportasyon gaya ng active transport, tricycle, private vehicles, gaya ng pribadong motorsiklo o kotse, o kaya naman ay kanilang mga company shuttle services. Hindi po ito nangangahulugan na wala na exemption sa polisiya. Ang dati pong abiso ngayon ay para lang, ang ating pong abiso ngayon ay para lang sa manggagawa. Exempted pa rin po sa polisiya ang mga kababayan nating may medical condition na pinagbabawalan sa pagkuha ng bakuna. Gayon din ang ating mga kababayan na mag-a-avail ng essential goods and services gaya ng pagkain, medical checkup at iba pa.
The Philippine government urged to conduct a national COVID vaccination day for children aged 5 to 11. The country's vaccination drive will be expanded to that age group starting February 4th. But the Philippine Medical Association says there should be a day when parents would concentrate in having their kids vaccinated. The group also stresses the need to separate the inoculations of children and adults.
Sana ma-separate yung bakunahan ng mga bata doon sa adult, kasi yung mga adult may mga kompletong may mga boosters, halo-halo yan, may first dose, second dose, kasi iba yung bakuna ibibigay sa mga bata.
The group also calls for the strengthening of information drives to encourage more parents to have their kids vaccinated.
Meanwhile, majority of children aged 12 to 17 in the Philippines are fully vaccinated against COVID-19. The health department says 58% of that age group has completed their doses since the vaccine rollout was expanded to them last October. According to the Pediatric Infectious Disease Society of the Philippines, 94% of adverse reactions were mild. The agency also notes there have been more than 396,000 COVID cases among those aged 19 and below.
Most COVID cases have been mild, but some patients have turned into severe with critical manifestations. Some have developed complications like multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children.
An infectious diseases specialist urges government to subsidize the cost of drugs for COVID treatment. Dr. Ronjin Sulante suggests state insurer PhilHealth should include the antiviral drug molnupiravir in its home treatment package. He says molnupiravir, when given within 5 days of onset of symptoms, prevents a patient's progression to a severe case by 30%.
There should be monitoring of the patients that should be given, but I think the bottom line, this is accessibility, and this accessibility should also include subsidy from the government, that it should be free for those who are really cannot afford this drug. For now, we don't have molnupiravir in most of these government hospitals. So unless there is the hospital procured for that, no, we're using remdesivir for these patients.